What's going on, guys? We've got the Dolphins 2023 roster grades. Obviously, they've got a pretty interesting roster. Gotta go through Tua, obviously. That's going to be a little fun. No, it's not going to be. Oh, either way, guys, 2023 Dolphins roster grades. Let's get into it. Here we go. And with that, what is going on, guys? Welcome back to the Thunderbolt. Of course, please like and subscribe. Hope you guys also enjoy this one. I got the Miami Dolphins 2023 roster grades for you guys. Obviously, a very good roster that many people just don't, like, talk about enough. I'll be honest. Obviously, last season, a bitter end of their season. Of course, they were 8-0-2 going into Week 13. And they got blown out by the 49ers. And then, obviously, got hurt in Week 16. Crazy season for the Dolphins last year. Roller coaster ride. This season, they're looking for a little more stability. And to be honest, they're you could argue, probably the toughest division in football. All that said, though, they've got a pretty solid roster. Do they have the best in the division? We'll see by the end of the year. But all I got to say is, let's get right into the roster. Starting out with Tua, this is a doozy. Here we go. Oh, this is so hard to grade Tua because, obviously, last year, there was a shot he would have won MVP. Maybe not with the way he ended. Like, through Week 12, he was probably the MVP favorite. I mean, to, like, 20-something touchdowns, 3 interceptions. Like, you can't argue with that. But at the same point with Tua, I mean, he's so, like, explosive, so accurate. He could throw the deep ball really, like really good touch. Again, he doesn't have an elite arm. He's never really had that. But he has his arm, you could still see, like, he has the arm to make the throws. Now that, though, he's probably, I'd be okay saying he's one of the most accurate passers in the NFL. I'm not even kidding with saying that. Like, he's top 5 in my opinion. He's got a, just so good at putting the ball in the right spot. His footwork's really good. But again, yeah, he threw a couple interceptions this year, but he was amazing when he was on the field. Like, he showed up, like, big time. But again, concussions, really scary. We don't know what's going on with him with that. So, again, 3 concussions is not good. Like, and 2 of them are really bad. So, for Tua, obviously missed those 3 games and then missed that end of the season as well with the concussion. So, it's a big issue with him. He's had issues in the past. Again, 2021, he missed some games. So, overall, Tua, he has not been healthy, like, really at all. Like, just, that's kind of how it's been. It's been a crazy start to his career, but you can't say it. He isn't an above-average quarterback right now, because he definitely is. Mike White as a backup isn't terrible, and Mike White, same type of thing, can't stay healthy. Yeah, 3 touchdowns, 4 interceptions, but he was definitely the best quarterback in the Jets. I'm going to be honest, he isn't great, but he does have flashes. Again, was crazy in that one game. He can come in and start a game and be okay for you, so I don't hate him as a backup. Can honestly come in and play pretty well. You've seen him play against good defenses. Skylar Thompson, same type of thing. He's actually stepped up as well. Again, played that wildcard game. Didn't play terrible. Again, wasn't good. But we didn't expect that. But in the game he started, he wasn't terrible. In that wildcard game, he wasn't terrible. So, Skylar Thompson, you don't want him starting for sure. Like, he's just not, like, an NFL quarterback. But he showed up when he needed to. Showed a little leadership there. James Blackman, obviously, at Arkansas State, the UDFA. This dude actually has a pretty good arm. But he's just not going from a big school. So, they've got 3 quarterbacks. I know Tua, I'm going to be surprised if he doesn't get hurt. I hope he can stay healthy. Like, that'll be huge for them. But same point, you never know he's going to be healthy. Tua, obviously, is a roller coaster of a quarterback. Let's get right into the grade, though. And for Tua, we talk, it's just, you can't, it's so hard to grade him because he was so crazy last year. It was insane. But Mike White as a backup, is he really better than Teddy Bridgewater? Maybe, but I think he can stay healthy. I don't know. The Dolphins are just, quarterback is just not stable. I don't want to put it. But people, there's 2 haters that'll say he's a C-caliber quarterback because, yeah, he was super hot that the first 8 games he started. But again, he just can't stay healthy and he implodes. So that's what the haters say. People who really like him will say, oh yeah, he's an A-minus quarterback around that range because he's been bet. You could argue he was the best quarterback last year when he was playing at his best. So that is very true as well. But I'm going to give him a B because I think that's where he lies right now. When Tua's on the field, the Dolphins always have a chance to win. He's shown he can win big games as well. Yeah, they've lost some other games, but Tua when he's on the field has been really good. So let's say 15, 30, 40. At the quarterback position, I think that's pretty fair. Yes, the injuries, but Tua, when he's on the field, has been good. That's just how it's been. Time for the running back position. And a running back for the Dolphins, obviously, they've got 3 dudes who are pretty confident in. I mean, Raheem Mostert, he's a weird running back, I'll put it that way, but there's no denying he can just straight up explode, like, blow up. And now that, though, he's been a very efficient back his whole career. Like, there really hasn't been a season where he's just sucked on efficiency. Like, he's always been an efficient back and one of the fastest players in the league. Yeah, he's getting older. He's 31 now, but he can still blow the doors off you. Not that though, he hits holes better than a lot of running backs, to be honest. Again, he's also not a terrible receiving back either. Can make some plays there. Again, super good at, with big plays. But again, you don't want him getting a million carries. He's just going to get hurt. Like, that's been what he's been like. Last year, though, he was pretty healthy for most of the season, which is good to see. Jeff Wilson Jr. is not a terrible back either. Again, he can handle a little more carries. Again, a couple more carries. None of that, though, he's actually a better receiving back as well. So, they've got two backs that are pretty solid overall, like, good number one, number two. But at the same point, like, neither of them are, like, top 10 backs, but they're pretty good. And then Devon Achane, another one of these speedsters. Jeff Wilson Jr. is not a power back either. So, they really don't have a guy who can just straight up go in the red zone and just pound it in, which was a problem for them at some points last year. Still don't have that, but Devon Achane is a straight-up speedster. He honestly would probably beat the fastest player in the NFL. You could argue that right now. He's so fast. But at the same point, it's kind of all he is. He's fast. Like, there's really no other way to put it. I mean, his vision isn't terrible, but he just that's kind of about it. Like, he's fast. Good for him. And Myles Gaskin, obviously, has had experience as a number one back, but he's kind of crap, not going to lie there. I mean, 2021. In 2020, he was kind of their starter. He was probably their number one back in 2021. 2020 was definitely their number one back. 2020 was not their number one back, but close to. Again, those 2 years, he got a lot of touches. He has experience as the number one back. Has he been good? No, he's been one of the worst backs in the league as a starter. But overall, they've got a pretty good backfield. It's depth, but I mean, like, there's a lot of depth, but is it that great? I don't know. Let's get right into their grade. And for the Dolphins backfield, I'll give them a B- because any one of those guys going in there, you know they're going to be efficient. You know they're going to be good. Yeah, is Myles Gaskin good? No, but he has shown he can start. And, like, the problem is they just don't have Raheem Mostert. And, again, they could have Dalvin Cook now, too. And if they get him, they'll be, like, an A- backfield. But they already have depth. They've got 1-2 punch at running back. I'm pretty solid with them. You could argue they're a C+ because they're, like, really not going to blow you away. But, again, they got a pretty not great line of backs between Raheem Mostert and Devon Achane are basically the same backs. But Jeff Wilson Jr. being there is a big help for them, obviously. So, I like how their backfield shaped up. So, I'll give them a B-. It comes to 3. What is that? 21 for this backfield. Time for the wide receiver position. If the Dolphins wide receiver, obviously the headliners are Tyreek Hill and Jalen Waddle. AJ Brown and Devontae Smith. They're probably the best wide receiver duo in the NFL. I'm gonna be honest there. Tyreek obviously second receiving yard. He's a top 5 receiver. He's still older, but he's still really fast. Obviously 2025. His guess is gonna be his last season. He's 2 more years. Jalen Waddle, he exploded last year. There's really no other way to put it. After 2021, where he averaged less than 10 yards per reception, he averaged 18.1, which led the league, which is just not something you're going to see every day. So, they got 2 really good receivers instead of Wilson Jr., who really didn't get much of an opportunity at all last year, I'm going to be honest. Like, just straight up didn't get any opportunities, but... And Tua's going to have to target him more this year because, I'm going to be honest, Tyreek Hill and Jalen Waddle, teams are going to figure out how to stop him. Maybe they won't, but whatever. Sarah Wilson Jr. needs to get more touches. Obviously, they have another speedster, and Robbie Chosen. I don't even know what the frick his name is. He is a speedster, obviously been in the league for a while. Had that great year in 2020, but not a terrible backup there. And Braxton Barrett's a really good gadget receiver. He's also pretty fast, if you didn't know that either. Like, and he has really good hands. Well, maybe not really good hands. He's got good hands. His route running stinks, though. River Craycraft, really good blocker. Definitely the best blocker on this team. Really good technically, but, won't blow you away with athleticism. He really struggles with separation. Eric Uzekamana, I mean, he got some playing time. Didn't see a lot of him, though. Freddie Swain, I was coming over for the Seahawks, isn't terrible either. So they've got, like, 8 good receivers. Not going to lie, like, guys that I'm pretty confident with. But obviously, their headliners are Tyreek Hill and Jalen Waddle. They've got a really good receiving core. And you can definitely argue Jalen Waddle's top 15 receiver. I'll give him an A- a receiver. The reason it's that higher is because, I mean, Cedric Wilson Jr. just didn't really do a lot last year. He didn't really get the chance to either. And I just don't know if, well, yeah, I want to give him an A, but just, I can't, that's how I'll put it. Honestly, I want to give an A so bad, but just, I don't know about Cedric Wilson Jr., and the other receivers aren't really proving themselves yet, so, A- at his wide receiver position, so, can they have basically everything but a guy I can really count it on third receiver? I want to give him an A, but it just doesn't sit right with me right now, so what is that? 18, 27, 30 points for this receiving core. Time for the tight end position. And for the Dolphins, Durham Smythe is their number one tight end. Last year was obviously, like, a great blocker, but that's kind of about it. I mean, he's like a bottom 10 tight end. I mean, he did take Mike Gesicki's spot, so I guess that's what they've got there. But, Tua likes him as a blocker. He's not terrible. Again, they also have Alec Ingold, who's probably the best, other than what is called Patrick Ricard, probably the best fullback in the league. Tyra Croft isn't a back and play on either. Again, he's bounced around the league a little bit, but not terrible. Eric Stauffer's not good, though. I mean, he's a decent receiver, but his blocking, oh my god. Don't have him in other, what's called Sirius situations. It won't end well. And Elijah Higgins, obviously, the sixth round pick at Stanford. Watch a lot of Terry McKee at Stanford. Got to watch a lot of Elijah Higgins, too. Very underwhelming, boring player, but he does get the job done. So, this tight end, is it good? No. Is it even above average? Is it close? Is it even good at all? Probably not, but I mean, it's okay, I guess. And for the Dolphins, I'll give Durham Smythe in this overall tight end a D+. I mean, Durham Smythe was okay last year, but I mean, he really isn't much of a receiver at all. And they don't have, like, an actual legitimate receiving threat, other than Eric Stauffer, who is a liability on the field, because even if he makes a play in the receiving game, it's not like, it's just too big of a risk, to be honest. So, this tight end, it leaves a lot to be desired. But I'm going to be honest, it's really not that big of a deal for them. Time for this offensive line. And for the Dolphins, across the offensive line, of course, Austin Jackson is the blindside blocker for, what is it called, Tua. And he is, you could argue, he's the most inconsistent blocker in the league. But I will say this, when he's on, you're not going to get around him. His run blocking has always been solid, too, but his pass blocking is, again, a complete mess. So, that's not great for Tua, but he's not a terrible tackle. He hasn't been a hit for them. Again, the first-round pick out of USC, but I still don't think he's terrible. Like, he's the reason he's still starting. Isaiah Wynn obviously struggled with injury. He's not a terrible backup again as well. When he's played, he's been okay. He hasn't been terrible, but Isaiah Wynn for sure is something that some guy who definitely has got to be out there. Lester Cotton Sr. is also not a terrible backup either. Like, I mean, these backups are all really solid. Dan Feeney, I mean, he sucks when he starts, but, I mean, he's, like, rotational type of what's called lead blocker type of play hasn't been terrible. And Robert Jones as well, he's hasn't really gotten much playing time, but he did look good in preseason, so I like what I got there. And Kendall Lamb obviously is a straight up just run blocker. I don't know what to put him. He's been in the league a while. He's really good at run blocking. Can't really do anything else, though. Teron Armstead did take a step back last year. Again, it was injured for most of the year. I mean, not most of the year, but he was injured for part of the year. He was pretty solid when he played, though. Liam Meichenberg has really stepped up this year. Really solid guard. Connor Williams, I mean, just one of the most underrated top centers in the league. He was really good last year. Robert Hunt, did he play well? I mean, but yeah, Connor Williams having there is good, but I mean, yeah. He was solid, but I mean, he did give him a couple sacks. Let me just put it that way. But Robert Hunt isn't terrible from the inside. But overall, this offensive line is pretty darn good. For this Dolphins offensive line, I'll give him a B. They definitely stepped up last year. The only problem with them is, are they really a type of offensive line that can just straight up move guys in the red zone? Absolutely not. I mean, that's just not going to work for them. If they ever had to be in such a goal line situation where they had to just straight up move guys to get them in the end zone, that's just not what they have there. Again, Teron Armstead is their best veteran there. But they have some really good depth as well. The only problem is Austin Jackson just isn't that great. And I mean, yeah, Liam Eichenberg took some steps up, but he isn't great. You know, I'll honestly give him a B+, because I do like this offensive line, to be honest. I think it's really good. So what does that come out to? They were a lot better last year. 6, 12, 18. That's 18 points for this offensive line. I like their offensive line a lot. Time for the overall offensive grade. Oh, yeah, FYI, I did change the offensive grade to a B. I mean, offensive line to a B. But I'm gonna be honest, so their grade does come out to a B-. So let's just equal 16 plus 6 plus 30. Plus, what was it, 21 plus 40. So, 113 points to this offense. I'm going to give them a B. So, here's why. Because you saw their offense when they were, like, on. They just straight up were unbelievable. I mean, like, they were you could argue they were the best offense in the league. Like, they were scoring 30 a game for sure. So, and just the way they won, like, every game was a little different, which was crazy to see. But they are the same type of offense as well. Like, their offense is probably even better. I mean, tight end really brings this grade down, but I still think this offense is a B. The reason they're not B+ is in the A range is because high risk, high reward. When they're at their best, they're great, but when they're at their worst, yeesh, they're not good. It's kind of like that there. That's what I got for this offense, though, guys. I think you could best they're like A+, like when they're at their absolute best, but at their worst, they're on the D range. So, but overall, as a roster, without overperforming or anything, I gotta give them a B because again, Tua, always a wild card. This running back position isn't crazy. This offensive line's good, but is it that great? We don't know for sure. And I like what they got there. A lot of good continuity. And the tight end room just isn't good either. So gotta keep that in mind too. Time for this linebacker core. And for this defense, obviously they do run a 3-4. So we'll just talk about these four guys really, because Zeke Vanderberg. Never heard of this dude in my whole life. I mean, He might probably won't make the roster either. But Ivory Miller Jr., I've heard a couple things. Aubrey Miller Jr., I've heard a couple things. Again, UDFA at Jackson State, if you didn't know, of course, played for Deion Sanders. Really athletic dude, but you really struggle to stay on the field consistently, like, playing-wise. And as well, obviously, isn't a good in pass coverage if you watch that. What was it? The Division II Championship. But, actually, though, this linebacking core is pretty good. Jerome Baker, I mean, he was honestly not terrible in 2019 as a, like, actual, like, first year, like, actually starting, but he's been a starter there for here for 5 years, and to be honest, he really hasn't had a great year in any of them, but he hasn't been terrible either. Like, his pass coverage has really improved. Like, last year, he was pretty good in coverage, but, definitely took a step back from 2021, where he was really a good asset for them and could really, like, make plays. Like, in 2021, that was probably his best year. 2020 was also really good, but I think 2021 was his best all-around year. Last year, you could argue he was a little bit better in coverage, but he missed more tackles. It wasn't effective in terms of making plays and stuff like that. And there were points in the season where he wasn't, like, good at all. Like, he struggled a lot. So, he missed a lot of tackles as well. So, Jerome Baker, like, he's a weird linebacker. He's definitely a starting caliber type of guy, though. Probably, like, a C-plus, a little bit of average. David Long Jr., though, yes, is he the best linebacker? No. But he's really, really good at setting the edge. I mean, you got really, like, really good at run defense. Now that, though, you're not going to beat him with leverage. Like, you got to be able to be just straight up stronger, bigger than him with that. Yeah, his coverage does leave a lot to be desired. But overall, he's not terrible. Channing Tindall, obviously, the third-round pick from last year, didn't play, like, really at all. I think he was, like, injured for part of the season as well. So, played a little special teams, but I want to see a little more of him. Obviously, really good in coverage, but that's kind of about it. I mean, he really did bail on Nakobe Dean a lot in college with the run defense, but he's a weird linebacker, to be honest. Duke Riley, he's played on a lot of teams his whole career. I mean, yeah, played for Philly the past couple years before that. He's just been a good vet on this team. I mean, he's not a terrible backup. They've got some good depth on this team, but again, if, like, they lose two linebackers, they're kind of screwed, but it's not, like, overwhelming at all, but they've got a pretty good linebacker core. For the Dolphins, I'll give them a B minus. So there's a good chance that a C plus. They're gonna play about a little bit above average, but I'm gonna give a B minus because I mean I really do like Channing Tindall a lot, and Duke Riley's been on a lot of teams. He's shown he can start, so overall I get some pretty good depth. But again, there's no one on that linebacker core. I'm like Jesus, like holy crap, you gotta watch out for him if you're the offense. But he's not. It works. It's serviceable. So what is that? 9, 18, 21 points for this linebacking core. Time for the defensive line. And for this defensive line, obviously speaking of the Dolphins, first things first. Zach Sealer was actually really good last year. He's gotten better every single year of his career. If you didn't know, he lived in a truck, which is pretty crazy. But yeah. 2021, he was probably better than last year, even though last year he definitely stepped up with pass rush, but 2021 was really, really effective in terms of just being able to make plays, like, made a lot of plays 2021, but last year, again, really good with pressures. He really got a good finesse game going against those really with power, but he's kind of the guy that comes in on third down if they need a guy who can just get off the quarterback. Jalen Twyman, again, just hasn't done anything in his career so far. I'm going to be honest there. So, that isn't great either. And Brandon Pilley, not Lester Cowan Sr., but Brandon Pilley, I'm going to be honest, at USC UDFA, he got jogged on in college. I'm not gonna lie there. Like, he wasn't great, but he does provide you some type of athleticism, some type of quickness on the interior, because Raekwon Davis is not going to add you any of that. He's just out there to basically glide up against the center and take over some spot. He's a zero tech, straight up your normal defensive lineman. But Emmanuel Ogbar and Christian Wilkins are really, really good. Christian Wilkins, I'm going to be honest, he's the most active interior defensive lineman in the league other than Aaron Donald. Even more than Chris Jones. Like, he makes so many plays. He, like, without them, the run defense is just straight up, like, mush. It's just not good. But he can also provide pressure. Christian Wilkins is one of the most underrated and most underappreciated guys in the league. He is in, like, A-minus range type of dude. Is he going to blow you away? No. But he is a very, very, very good interior defensive lineman. Emmanuel Ogba, obviously known for his pass rushing specialty. Kind of what he does. He's done that his whole career. Getting a little older, though, so he's maybe losing a step. But Emmanuel Ogba, really good interior specialist there. Is a liability in the run and run defense, though, again. But still has pretty good chop cut there. So I do like what they got in this interior. It's pretty darn good. Dolphins interior defensive line. I want to give them an A, but can I really do that? Let's see. They've got four dudes. I'm like, really? Yeah. I'll give him a B. I gotta give him an A minus. Emmanuel Ogba, yes, he can be great in run defense. No, but that's why they have Raekwon Davis and Zach Sealer. But The Dolphins are just the defensive line. I mean, their defensive line is just so underrated. Like, you gotta realize their run defense. The fact they have three guys that can straight up just play three tech is huge. And not that though, but Emmanuel Agba is such a threat in pass rush in off the edge and just overall like in stunts and stuff. You just can't obviously just can't like ignore him. And even more importantly, again, it's only worth 2 points for grade. So I just keep that in mind too. But Christian Wilkins is such a good anchor player. He's just so good. It's awesome to see him. So what is that? 6, 12, 18, 20 points for this defensive line. Time for this overall pass rushing grade. And looking at the Dolphins, their edge rushers are good, but are they great? And that's something that's just not there right now, in my opinion. Because Bradley Chubb, I mean, last year he was supposed to be good, but he really fell off after leaving the Broncos. Like, he was a disappointment with the with the Dolphins, like, last year. It just wasn't great. Obviously, 2020 was his big bounce back year after the bad 2019. But 2022, he wasn't terrible either. Again, got hurt, though. So, Bradley Chubb's just had a mess of a career. I mean, he hasn't been, like, again, for a fifth overall pick, I mean, they got a lot back for him. But at the same point, like, he's been a little disappointing for his career. And as well, obviously, Jalen Phillips is a freaking monster. He is really good. Like, Jalen Phillips is really good. Like, yeah, did he have less sacks last year? Yes, but my God. He had, like, 50 pressures. It was crazy. Jalen Phillips is so good. Like, yeah, there is a little bit, like, he's so athletic, too. Again, Jalen Phillips, I think he's going to have, like, 15 sacks this year. Like, Jalen Phillips is going to be amazing. Like, he's so good already, but, like, Jalen Phillips is so, you watch him on film, you're like, oh, God. Like, he's not, like, Nick Bosa or TJ Watt good, but he's really good. Jalen Phillips is a really good player. And you look at their depth. I mean, Andrew Van Ginkle is actually a guy who can kick out. Is he a great pass rusher as a whole? No. He gets shut down a lot. But overall, is he just run defender, setting the edge, being consistent? Like, you know what you can get out of him. He's going to make a lot of good plays. And also, Malik Reed is not a terrible guy either. Really good at setting the edge. He isn't going to get a ton of sacks. But again, I like the fact they've got two guys behind Jalen Phillips and Bradley Chubb that are serviceable type of dudes. This pass rush is really good. The problem is it always underperforms with, like Jalen Phillips just being there. Bradley Chubb's got to be better than he was last year. Because, yeah, the interior is going to get the pressure, but Bradley Chubb's got to win the one-on-ones. Because Jalen Phillips can get triple teams, probably. I mean, he's so good. Let's get right to the pass rushing grade, though. The problem with the Dolphins' pass rush is it's so well-rounded. It looks so good on paper, but I always know they always underperform. So, I'm going to give their pass rush an A-, though, because I don't care. There's games they don't show up, but I mean, like, you can't ignore that on paper. Jalen Phillips in that interior is just so, so good. I gotta give him the A-. I don't understand. Like, A- is what I have to give him. Like, I can't ignore that. Like, many people give him a B+, but honestly, you know, I'll give him a B+. Like, I'll be off Jalen Phillips for a little bit, but he's so good. 12-24, what the heck was that? 36 points for this pass rush. Time for the cornerback grades. And obviously, the big news for the Dolphins was getting Jalen Ramsey in the offseason for a third-round pick and, really nothing. They just got, like, basically got him for free. But Jalen Ramsey, is he still the best corner in the league? Probably not. But you can still argue he is because he had a couple games where he stunk. Against the Saints, against the Bills. But other than a couple games, he was still shut down. Like, really, really good. He had 88 total tackles. That was, like, top five in the league in terms of corners. 4 interceptions. Was still really good. Got targeted a lot, yes. But I still think he's a top 3 corner. I wouldn't say he's I'd say Pat Surtain is probably the best corner in the league right now. Then probably Sauce Gardner. But Jalen Ramsey's top 3, to be honest. Still got a Pro Bowl. Still very, very good. Xavien Howard, he did fall off a little bit this year. I mean, 2020, he was better than 2021. Obviously, 2020 was by far his best year as a corner. Now in 10 interceptions, though, but he didn't give up anything. Like, he was insane. Last year, though, still really underrated, still a really good player. Xavien Howard's still a really good corner. So they got the top 2 really good guys. Kohu, don't even know how to pronounce it. He got targeted 115 times. He's a really good workhorse corner. He's not going to miss a lot of tackles. Yeah, he'll give him a couple catches game, but guy would have stepped in a lot for Byron Jones, who obviously isn't on this team anymore. He's a really good slot option. Nick Needham, I mean, he's kind of a lost cause at this point, I'm going to be honest there. Keon Cross and Justin Bethel aren't terrible backups, so again, no Ake Benogany, kind of a bust. Trill Williams has been on the team for a while. So a lot of experience, I mean, not for a while, but he's been on this team. So a lot of experience in this team, I mean, other than Kader KU, but he's still on this team, so yeah. They've got, like, really good continuity here, other than Jalen Ramsey coming in, but this quarterback room overall is really solid. If the Dolphins a quarterback, I still got to give him an A-, because, I mean, like, they've got three legit corners, and they've got depth. Like, there's really nothing to complain about. Yeah, Jalen Ramsey, is he, still the best corner in the league? No. I'm not bawling over him like I was with Jalen Phillips, but he's still really good. And obviously, Xavier Howard, you could argue, still number corner. He's probably number corner, too. So with all that in mind, I mean, they've got a really good quarterback room. What does that come out to? 6, 12, 18, 20 points for this quarterback room. Time for the safety group. And in safety for the Dolphins, it's a little bit of a mixed bag, to be honest. Veron McKinley III, of course, a UDFA out of Oregon. I mean, not a UDFA for Oregon. Yeah, he is a UDFA. What the heck? I'm confused with him. He played for Oregon with, obviously, Javon Holland for a couple years. He wasn't good, but, I mean, he's on the team. He's shown a lot. Like, I do like the fact that they have him with Javon Holland, though, because, again, they've got some really good connections there. Not only that, though, he can actually cover better than Javon Holland in some situations, so I like that a lot. Deshaun Elliott last year played a huge role for the Lions. He was their number one safety, like, overall, like, probably the most consistent player in their secondary. Did with the whole season. He's really struggled with health overall, but really athletic type of interesting type of player. The only problem with him is he's just not really very, like, good in coverage. I don't know how to put it. Like, he isn't going to wow you at all there, but still a really good tackler, really good anchor there. I really like him a lot. Obviously, Javon Holland is the headliner for the safety run. He is really, 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 really good, but still can improve in coverage, so that's what I'll say there. And Brandon Jones isn't terrible either as a safety. I mean, he's been in the league for, what is it, a couple years now. He played a lot. I think he started a little bit, too. So, overall, I like the secondary. I mean, they've got a pretty good safety room again. Veron McKinley III is probably not the greatest backup, but the fact that Javon Holland is just really good kind of shadows that out a little bit. Overall, I like this safety room, though. And wrapping up the defense with this safety grid, I'll honestly give him a B+. The reason they're not an A is because Veron McKinley, whatever, pronounce it the way you want it. He's not, like, a backup caliber player right now, and yeah, I like Brandon Jones a lot. They've got three really good safeties, but Javon Holland, one more year of him being, like, legit, and they've got an A safety room. I'm not concerned about Deshaun Elliott. Other than the fact that if he gets hurt, Brandon Jones starting wouldn't be the greatest. Their secondary has gotten torched before, but overall, I mean, their secondary is really good. So, B+ there. That comes out to, 9, 18, 27 points for the safety room. This defense is going to have a really high grade because it's on paper. Let's get right to it. And the average for the grade of this defense comes out to a B+, which is honestly perfect for them. On paper, they are probably a top 10 defense, but do they play like that? They haven't since 2020, I'm going to be honest with you. I mean, 2021, they were at points there, but last year, I mean, they just didn't, like, they underperformed once Bradley Chubb got there. I'm going to be completely honest there, but they still got a really good defense, 124 total points. I like what they got going there. Obviously, this team's got a really good defense, on paper at least, so that's pretty good there. Time for the special teams grade. Here we go. And for, last time in the depth chart, but when we look at this Dolphins, special teams unit. First things first, Jason Sanders is their kicker. He's basically dead average. I mean, last year he was very accurate, no, but years before he was pretty good. 2021, he struggled a lot, but 2020, he was really, really, really good. Like, really good. But honestly, he's not, like, great, but, like, he's a good kicker. I mean, yeah, and he's got a decent leg, too, so I like Jason Sanders. He's, like, a solid kicker. Jake Bailey, obviously coming over from the Patriots. He had a really good rookie season in 2020, but, I mean, he had, like, three really solid seasons last year. He got hurt, though, and he wasn't really good when he played, so that's just what I got there, and obviously, he's looking for a bounce back this year. Got suspended by the Patriots, too, so it's kind of turning down to the thing. And Michael Turk as well. They got him UDFA at Arizona State. He kicks bombs. I mean, that's kind of about it, though. Like, not very accurate with his bunts, but whatever. Braxton Barrios, really solid returner. If he doesn't muffle punt this year, that would be great. But he's obviously a very, very good returner. So that's what they got him there. And again, Blake Ferguson isn't a terrible long snapper either. He's been in the league for a couple years now, and it's been solid. So that's what I got for this Dolphins special teams unit. Let's get right to their grade. In regards to the Dolphins special teams unit, I'm going to give them, I'll give them a C+, because, yeah, Braxton Berrios is good, but Jason Sanders isn't anything special. Kicker, like, he's solid. But Jake Bailey is kind of a question mark in punter, because we haven't really seen him a lot. And again, he did not play that well last year. So, comes out to 3-6 points for this special teams unit. I mean, it's kind of around average. I'll give him a C+, though, because, again, they have Braxton Berrios at returner. So, that's what I got there, guys, for this special teams unit. Now, let's get this overall team depth grade. Here we go. If for the Dolphins, talking about their depth, obviously quarterbacks is the most important position for them at depth, because obviously they don't have any depth, they're kind of screwed, because if Tua might get hurt, and probably will get hurt, so keep that in a C there. I don't think, like, Mike White, is he any better than Teddy Bridgewater? I don't know for sure. Running back depth, probably a B+. I mean, Devon Achane starting isn't good, but I mean, he can break something big, I guess. Wide receiver, A-, I think that's pretty fair. I don't want to cap him there, but they've got pretty good depth there. Tight end, D+, because no one is better than Durham Smythe. Offensive line, B+, they've got two good depth on their offensive line. You got an argue though. Offensive depth, B. I think that's pretty fair there. Linebacker depth is probably a C+. I mean, it's a little shaky, but it's okay. Defensive line depth, C, actually, because, again, Zach Sealer is the only one who's really that good on that defensive line, other than the guys who are obviously starting. Pass rush depth, about a B. I mean, they've got some guys who can do some stuff, but they don't have, like, 10 threats. Cornerback, it's not the Patriots cornerback type of factory they've got running there, but it's probably about a B. It's good. It's not going to kill you if, like, someone gets hurt. Safety, though, C- maybe. It's not great if they all get hurt. So I'm going to give them about a B- there, and overall, I think this Dolphins team depth is about a B-, because they're not thin, but they play like they're thin. I don't know how to put it. Like, on paper, they don't seem like they're a thin team, but when they lose someone, especially Tua, it doesn't seem to be great. So what does that come out to? I think it's like 28 points. So their depth is good. It's not great, though. Yeah, it's kind of what you get there. Time for the identity, though, which is really important. For this Dolphins team, their defense really doesn't have the depth I want them to. Like, Vic Fangio coming in will really give them the depth they need, to be honest. Like, Vic Fangio for this defense is going to make them be, like, they're a B+. I do think they're going to be the second best defense in the NFL this year, outside of the Patriots. You know, they're going to be top 5, though. I think Vic Fangio is going to come in here and make this defense a juggernaut, to be honest. So, that identity is really not about this defense. Obviously, they don't know what they're going to want to do. They're going to want to play a lot of, what is it called? A lot of cover three, like heavy cover three. They're going to want to put Jalen Phillips in the best spot where he can get the quarterback and also help out other guys like Bradley Chubb. Offensively, though, that's where it's kind of a crapshoot, to be honest, because Tua gets hurt, what are they going to do? They can't bomb the ball down the field, can they? And obviously, they run a lot of unique plays. They run the ball a lot in a shotgun, which is okay, I guess, for them, but I do think they have to run the ball a little more this year, and again, Tua is going to have to be on the field if they want to really be able to do what they want to. So, overall, I do think they have a pretty solid identity. I'll give them a B+ here. I like what they're going to want to do, because again, this defense is rock solid. Cover three. Get a lot of soft shell there. Again, that's the Fangio scheme. So keep that in mind there. But again, it's going to be a lot of those linebackers and Dave Long Jr. and Jerome Baker. Those guys can really hold up and really be a good with leverage, which is what Dave Long Jr. really was brought in to do. Maintain leverage, hold gaps, do your job. Basically, that's kind of what we got there. So B+ is what I got. That comes out to, what is that, 15, 30, 45 for this identity. I think they got what they want to do down. Time for this overall roster grade now, which is going to be interesting. And gonna be honest, so it comes out to a B for their overall average roster grade. Again, 316 points is really good overall. The Chiefs had an A- grade, and they also had like 331 points. So I'll get, wait, what do they have? A-. I'll give them a B+. I think that's pretty fair. So this roster's really good. It's like really solid on paper. It's that A range roster because again, they have a couple positions where I'm like, eh, but overall, it's really solid, and I like what they're going to do here. So, on paper, they got a pretty, really good roster. Really good roster. Be honest, honestly, they've got the same type of roster as the Bills, and I do think that maybe the Bills roster is a little better, but, and the Jets roster probably is better, but they definitely have a roster that can definitely compete with the Dogs in the AFC. They definitely have a good roster. The only problem is, they play in Miami, don't want to have to go anywhere cold. They got to win the big games. B+ for this Dolphins roster grade. I want to give them a higher grade. Their points, I think, are going to come in handy for them, though. So, A-, maybe that would be reaching a little bit, though. I do think they have a really good roster. B+ for this Dolphins team. See you in the next one, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed.
After the stop by Thomas, they'll run it with Howe. Another first down for Carolina. There he goes. Sam Howe for the touchdown. Are you serious?
This is an incredible run by Sam Howe. First, look at the move in space. Keep on the zone read. That's an excellent job. And then running through contact, Wesley Walker there. You know, Ely there. I mean, it's crazy that he had that type of power for the move in space and then the power to finish.